In our earlier video, we have seen that Harris tells his experience of entering the maze at Hampton Court. So he goes with his country cousin, and before entering he had studied the map. And according to the map, it was very easy to cross the maze. Just he had to take right turn. And so he was very confident that he would come out of the maze. So when he entered, he met some people. They were wandering in the maze for nearly 45 minutes. So Harris confidently told that he would be able to take them out, and he asked them to follow him, and the people started to follow. Now let's see ahead what happens next. They picked up various other people who wanted to get it over as they went along until they had absorbed all the persons in the maze. Now when they moved further, there were many other people, so they picked up various other people. They asked various other people to join them so that they could come out of the maze. And in this way, they absorbed all the persons in the maze. Absorb means carried. So all the people started following Harris. People who had given up all hopes of ever getting either in or out, or of ever seeing their home and friends again, plucked up courage at the sight of Harris and his party and joined the procession, blessing him. So the people who were already there, lost in the maze, they had given all their hopes. They thought that they would never come out of the maze, and they would never see their friends and their family members again. So when they saw the confidence of Harris, they also plucked up courage. Plucked up courage means they gathered courage. They forced themselves to be brave, and they joined Harris and his party, the other people who were following Harris, and joined the procession, blessing him. So the other people also joined the procession. Procession is a line in which people walk in an orderly manner. So all were walking in an orderly manner. So everyone in the maze joined that procession so that they would be able to come out of the maze. And they also started blessing Harris, as he was the one who confidently said that he would take them out from that maze. And so they believed him and started blessing him. Harris said he should judge there must have been 20 people following him in all, and one of women with a baby who had been there all the morning insisted on taking his arm for fear of losing him. Now Harris said to the narrator that almost there were 20 people in the maze. In that, there was one lady who had a baby, who carried a baby with her. And that lady was in the maze since morning. Since morning she was wandering here and there, but she could not find the exit. So she insisted Harris on taking his arm. So she insisted Harris on taking his arm means to hold his arm. She said that I don't want to get lost in this maze again. She was afraid of getting lost in the maze, and so she insisted Harris to hold her hand. So you can see how the lady is holding the hand and they are trying to find the exit from the maze. Harris kept on turning to the right, but it seemed a long way, and his cousin said he supposed it was a very big maze. So as per the guidelines given in the map, Harris kept on turning to the right, but it was a very long way. They walked for a long time, but still they could not find the exit. And his cousin said he supposed it was a very big maze. So Harris' cousin also said that yes, it was a very big maze, because they were keeping on turning to the right direction, but still they were unable to find the exit. Oh, one of the largest in Europe, said Harris. So Harris replied that it is one of the largest maze in Europe. Yes, it must be, replied the cousin, because we have walked a good 2 miles already. So his cousin replied that you are right, it must be the largest maze in Europe, because they had walked for 2 miles and still they couldn't find the exit. Harris began to think it rather strange himself, but he held on until at last they passed the half of a piece of cake on the ground that Harris's cousin swore he had noticed there 7 minutes ago. So Harris also thought that it was strange that they couldn't come out, they couldn't find the exit. But he did not tell anything. He held on until at last they passed half of a piece of cake on the ground. So till they saw half of the piece of cake on the ground, Harris did not say anything. So Harris' cousin, when he saw the piece of the cake, Harris's cousin swore is the past tense of swear. So he swore that he had noticed the same piece of cake 7 minutes ago. Harris said, oh, impossible. But the woman with the baby said, not at all, as she herself had taken it from the child and thrown it down there just before she met Harris. So when Harris's cousin swore that he had seen the same piece of cake 7 minutes ago, at that time Harris said that it was not possible. But the lady who was carrying the baby, she said that she herself had taken that piece of cake from her baby and she had thrown it there on the ground just before she met Harris. So before she met Harris, she had thrown that piece of cake on the ground. She also added that she wished she never had met Harris and expressed an opinion that he was an imposter. So now she started blaming Harris. She said that she must not have ever met him. Just he kept her wandering in the maze. And she also called him imposter. Imposter means fraud, cheater, because he was not knowing the way and he said that he was knowing. So she called him imposter. That made Harris mad. and he produced his map and explained the theory. So when she called him imposter, Harris became angry and he showed the map and he explained the theory given in that map. "The map may be all right enough," said one of the party, "if you know whereabouts in it we are now." So one of the party said that the map may be right enough, but now you tell us about our whereabouts, means where we are now, show that in the map. So in the map you can show where we are so that we can take the proper direction. Harris didn't know and suggested that the best thing to do would be to go back to the entrance and begin again. So now Harris also did not know where they were. He was not able to show in the map about their whereabouts. And so he thought that it would be better if they go back to the entrance again and begin their journey again. Okay, for the beginning again part of it, there was not much enthusiasm, but with regard in the advisability of going back to the entrance, there was complete unanimity, and so they turned and trailed after. So now when Harris told other people that they should go back to the entrance and they should come again, at that time, for the beginning again part means to begin the again from entrance, to begin again to find the exit, for that part nobody agreed. There was not much enthusiasm, but to go back, all the people agreed unanimously. They agreed that they should go back. And so they turned out and trailed after Harris again. So they turned in the opposite direction and they trailed out, means they followed Harris once again in the opposite direction. About 10 minutes more passed and then they found themselves in the center. So again they started to walk in the opposite direction. They walked for 10 minutes and again they found themselves in the center, in the middle of that maze. Harris thought at first of pretending that that was what he had been aiming at, but the crowd looked dangerous and he decided to treat it as an accident. So when they came back to the center again, Harris thought of pretending that it was his aim to bring them back to the center, but when he looked at the people, the crowd looked dangerous. Now the people became dangerous because now they were frustrated, and so Harris decided to treat it as an accident. Anyhow, they had got something to start from then. They did know where they were and the map was once more consulted. Now, they had something to start from. Now, they started walking in the opposite direction and they came again in the center. So, now again, they have to start from there. Now they did not know where they were, and so once again the map was consulted. Once again Harris looked at the map to find the directions, and the thing seemed simpler than ever, and off they started for the third time. So when Harris looked at the map, it looked very simple. It was simpler than earlier And so once again they started for the third time. And 3 minutes later they were back in the center again. So again after 3 minutes they came back to the same position in the middle, in the center of the maze. After that they simply couldn't get anywhere else. Whatever way they turned brought them back to the middle. So now third time also happened same. After that whenever they started to walk in any direction it brought them back again to the center. It became so regular at length that some of the people stopped there and waited for others to take a walk round and come back to them. So now that became so regular at length. At length means for a long time. So for a long time it happened the same. In any direction they went, they came back to the center. So now some of the people they stopped there and they waited for the other people to take a round and come back to the center. Harris drew out his map again after a while, but the sight of it only infuriated the mob. So once again Harris tried to remove the map, but the sight of the map infuriated the mob, made the mob angry, made the people angry. And they told him to go and curl his hair with it. So the people in the maze, they told Harris to curl his hair with the map. Harris said that he couldn't help feeling that to a certain extent he had become unpopular. So Harris said that he started feeling that he became unpopular among the people. In the beginning, when he was confident about the way to the exit, he became popular among the people. But now, as again and again they reached the same position in any direction they walked, now he started feeling that he was unpopular among the people. They all got crazy at last and sang out for the keeper, and the man came and climbed up the ladder outside and shouted out directions to them. So now all were very angry. They became crazy. They were mad with anger. They sang out for the keeper. Means they called for the keeper of that maze. So the keeper, he came and climbed up the ladder from outside. So from outside the maze, the keeper climbed up the ladder. He shouted to them about the directions, in which direction they have to walk. He looked from above and he started to show the direction. But all their heads were by this time in such a confused whirl that they were incapable of grasping anything, and so the man told them to stop where they were and he would come to them. Now when he started to tell the direction, at that time people were mad with anger and so they were not able to understand what he was telling, what directions he was giving. They were in a confused whirl. Confused whirl means dizzy with confusion. There was lot of confusion among the people and so they were not able to grasp what the keeper was telling from above. So the keeper said them to wait where they were, and he decided to go inside and show them the direction. They huddled together and waited, and he climbed down and came in. So they came close together and they waited there for the keeper. All the people in the maze, they came together and they waited for the keeper to come and show them the direction. He was a young keeper, as luck would have it, and new to the business, and when he got in, he couldn't find them. So now he was the new keeper of that maze, and he was also new to this business. He had never done this job earlier. And so when he got in the maze, he couldn't find the people. And he wandered about trying to get them, and then he got lost. So now he wandered here and there trying to find the other people, and he himself got lost in the maze. They caught sight of him looking around every now and then, rushing about the other side of the hedge, and he would see them and rush to get to them, and they would wait there for about 5 minutes, and then he would reappear. Again, in exactly the same spot. So when he got lost, the people got sight of him looking round every now and then. So people were looking around every now and then. Continuously they were trying to find the keeper, and the keeper was trying to find the people. So the people got sight of the keeper. They saw the keeper. He was rushing about the other side of the hedge. So the keeper was on the other side of the hedge, and he would see them and rush to go get to them. So keeper would also see them, and he used to rush, hurry to get to them. And they would wait there for about 5 minutes. So when they would see each other, the people would wait there for the keeper for about, say, 5 minutes. And then he would reappear again in exactly the same spot and ask them where they had been. So and then again, the keeper would reappear in the same spot, exactly the same spot where he had got sight of the people, and again he used to disappear, and again he used to reappear. So in this way it was going on. Now he was also not able to bring them out of the maze to show them the exit. They had to wait till one of the old keeper came back from the dinner before they got out. So they had to wait for the old keeper. The old keeper had been for dinner. So after he came from dinner, he showed the direction to the new keeper as well as the other people who were lost in the maze. And then they all were able to come out. I hope you have understood the lesson, Harris in the Maze. Thank you.